Hello, my name is Stjepan Dujmovic and I'm product manager for our ADAS middleware solution.
And I'm Kosmas Petridis, working as a product field manager for ADAS AD solutions.
And today we would like to present our ADAS specific middleware solutions and all the advantages that you get when you choose our solution. Okay, but before we talk about middleware solutions, let's talk about something completely different. Let's talk about ketchup bottles. I love ketchup, but I don't like ketchup bottles. And there's a number of reasons for that. First, it's sometimes really difficult to get the ketchup out of the bottle if you open up a new ketchup bottle. Second, I never go for just a few drops of ketchup. I always want to have a nice blob. Third, it's quite difficult or almost impossible to get the same quantity of ketchup on two different plates. And last but not least, ketchup is always risky for white shirts. You're always in danger of getting some ketchup stains on your shirt. When you compare ketchup bottles to the ADAS development, you will see that there are quite a number of similarities. First, before you can start with ADAS development, you need to set up your development system. So you need to spend some effort before you can really start developing your ADAS and ID system. Second, you never go for small quantities of data if you develop ADAS systems. You're not going for bytes or kilobytes. You're always going for megabytes, terabytes, or even higher. Third, it's almost impossible to get the same quantity, which means we need a reproducible system for ADAS development, and this is something which comes not by default. We have a dynamic system, and reproducible behavior is not the default behavior. And last but not least, we have high requirements for functional safety when we are developing an ADAS and AD system. So you see, even if ketchup bottles have nothing to do with ADAS and AD system, there are quite a number of interesting similarities. Let's talk more about the challenges of ADAS and AD system and how we can solve these challenges with a good middleware solution. But before I give you more details about our solution, let me shortly define what I understand when I talk about middleware solutions. So as you can see on the graphic, we still have the hardware. We have on top of the hardware our operating system. And on top of this operating system, we have the middleware solution. And then you can see on top of the middleware solutions, we have all the different ADAS applications, which could be something like video perception, radar perception, but also driving and parking functions. So these are all different applications which are running on top of the middleware. And the middleware is making sure that all these applications can talk to each other. So the middleware is the communication backbone of the complete system. So let's talk about the evolution of electronic control units, or ECUs like we like to call them. In the past 20, 30 years ago, we had one ECU. The ECU was built on top of a microcontroller, and everything was built inside this ECU specifically for the customer project. So we had specific hardware, we had basic software, we had the application software, and the complete ECU, including the software, was delivered as one unit to the customer. When we compare this situation to the situation we have today, it's a completely different situation. We still have an electronic control unit, an ECU, but today we have much more powerful hardware. So if we have multiple microcontrollers, we have also powerful microprocessors, and you see that the software is also split up to a really fine granularity. So we have a separate operating system, which can be chosen by the customer. We have a basic software, we have a middleware, and we have different applications. And all these components on the software side can be provided by different suppliers. And we still need to make sure that these different software components properly work together. And that's exactly the task of the middleware. The middleware needs to make sure that the different applications from the different suppliers can properly work together. So the middleware is really the backbone of a modern ADAS system. As middleware solutions are important, there are already available solutions on the market. And the most important ones are the AutoSAR solutions. And as we are talking about a microprocessor system, Autos are Adaptive is the already available solution. So why are we developing a new ADAS-specific middleware solution if Autos are Adaptive is already available? We have the feeling that Autos are Adaptive is not covering all the requirements that we have for ADAS and AD system. Let's talk about these requirements. First, we need to be able to handle multiple streams of high bandwidth sensor data. So the middleware solution needs to be prepared to handle this big amount of data. And we can have even more than 10 gigabytes per second in a standard ADAS AD system. Second, we need, as discussed before, a reproducible behavior. So we want to have a deterministic recompute so that we can use this recompute for simulation-based validation, but also for debugging during development. And last but not least, we need functional safety in an ADAS and AD system. So we need to support systems up to ASIL D. And this is why the standard solutions are not enough. We need more. And this is the reason why we develop a specific ADAS and AD solution for middleware. And now my colleague Kosmas will give you more details about our middleware solution.
Thank you, Stjepan, for this nice explanations. Now let's take a closer look on the topic of recompute. If you are developing AD functions, you're usually interested in the behavior of the AD function. For this, you're utilizing a process where you feed in measurement data, execute the recompute of the function itself, and analyze the results. So this process is utilized by numerous use cases, like debugging, like computation of key performance indicators, and also in the testing. It is very important in all of these use cases that every time you're executing a recompute based on the same data and the same functionality, you're getting also the same results. This is what we are calling deterministic recompute. Moreover, if you encounter an error or a bug on the target itself, it is very important that you are able to reproduce this behavior in order to do a root cause analysis. And if I say reproduce this behavior, I mean really the exact behavior, including also timing effects. Furthermore, in the context of regression testing, you need to be able to integrate your recompute in automatization pipelines and also to be able to apply this on a large volume of data and also to be integratable in scaled execution environments. Fortunately, all of these capabilities are supported based on our ADAS AD middleware solution. Let's shift now the focus on the ECU execution itself. There you will encounter numerous sensors like cameras, lidars, radars, and all of these sensors are producing a high amount of data. This data are central inputs for AD functions, for various AD functions, which means that you have now to shift across the ECU a high amount of data. And this means that you need a lot of computational power for this. We have introduced a zero-copy approach, which enables you to save such computational power, which you can now utilize for the calculation of the AD functions itself, which is then improving the overall system performance. So, and now I would like to give back to Stjepan, who will give us an overview about the AD middleware package.
Thank you, Kosmas, for your explanation. Let's talk about the content of our middleware solution. So what is it that you get when you choose our middleware solution? It's not only a piece of software, it's a complete software development kit, which is our middleware solution. The first and probably most important component is a specification language. With that specification language, you can specify your functional components, you can specify the input and output of each component, and you can specify how the components are connected to each other. Second, you have a number of development components, of tools, which help you to develop your system. So we have code generation tools, which take the specification and generate a C++ code out of the specification. We have different visualization tools, which allows you to analyze your graphical representation of your system. We have IDE support for your integrated development environment. We have different analysis tools, and we have tools which support the simulation of your system. And last but not least, we also have different runtime components, which make sure that your middleware solutions behaves exactly the way it should. These runtime components are, for example, the middleware abstraction. We have a communication library, which makes sure that you have the zero copy communication. We have an activation management. We have a runtime monitoring, which makes sure that you can detect if certain components break down and that you can react to this breakdown. And last but not least, we also have support for the hardware accelerators, which are available in your system. So you see, our middleware solution is not just a piece of software, it's a complete software development kit supporting the complete development cycle of ADAS and AD systems. Okay, after we've talked about the content of our middleware solution, let's talk about how is our middleware solution integrated into the customer software. And you can see in this graphic, we have on the bottom line, we have the hardware. We have on the left side, the microcontroller. On top of this microcontroller, you have an OSEC operating system, and you have ADAS Classic running on top of this OSEC operating system. On the right side, you have the microprocessor with a POSIX operating system. And on top of this POSIX operating system, you have ADAS Adaptive, and you have our ADAS specific middleware solution. What does this mean? This means our middleware solution is not built to run standalone as the only solution. So in a real project, you will need other middleware solutions which are running in parallel, and you will need to communicate between the different middleware solutions. And on top of our middleware solutions, you have a perception layer, a planning layer, and you have the different driving and parking functions. And these different functionalities are accompanied by development tools for the architecture and design on one hand, and for the recomputation on the other side. So you see, it's a complete software development kit to support development of ADAS and AD systems. Let me finish this presentation by summarizing the major points. So what are the main benefits that you get? You get a deterministic recompute, which is important for the development. You get a high performance communication, which is important for your high bandwidth sensor data. And last but not least, you also get a system to support requirements for functional safety up to ASIL-D. What are the benefits that you get? You can accelerate your development cycle. You can seamlessly integrate the middleware solution into your available development environment. You can go for faster debugging. And last but not least, you can massively reduce the number of physical test miles by using simulation-based validation. So all in all, our middleware solution is providing a way of making your ADAS and AD development more efficient and avoiding the ketchup bottle problems for your system.
Thank you for watching this video. Hope you enjoyed it. And
if you are interested to learn more about our middleware solution, you can either visit our website or you can contact us directly. Thank you very much.